seventh grade through 12. Well, our situation is kind of unique. Believe it or not, my wife is commuting to the East Coast every day from Alpharetta. So she drives 50 miles there, 50 miles back there. So she leaves at 6 o'clock in the morning, drops them off at 7:15. She starts 15 again, so 4 to 5:15, 5:15, 15. So she's basically, they have a program called they're not boring, but it's very, they're the exception. So there's 23 countries represented in that project. Because the boring.
Tornado weather looks like from well over 10,000 feet up in the air above Georgia. It is non-stop. Just non-stop. It's been going like this for the past 20 minutes. Got a good one there. Several airplanes. There's one right above the cloud that is in front of us. And there's some below also.
It's
my older son was never seen anything like this. I'm so blessed.
Well, it's just that we're holding out right now, and we'll get you updated in a minute.
I missed a good one over here. This is, most of the activity is on this left side, so I have a limited view from my window. However, it won't stop. Every side. This is the heart of it.
It's a full one, and then all we have are marines. So I mentioned the ROTC.
consider the left side of the storm. Now we're on the north side of the storm. Oh my gosh. It's just non-stop lightning. So basically, we're trying to go around this thing. We're already delayed from a 6:20 flight to an 8:10 flight, which really left after 9:30 for another delay while we were on the tarmac. And as you can see, this is the reason why. I'm happy I can see this and not... Yeah. And not under it or in it. So we're gonna head for some turbulence now. Over 6 minutes now in this video, but this has been going on for well over 20 to 30 minutes. We're going again. We're going to the left side. Side of the storm again. So, and there's more towards the distance. It's faint, but you can see it. It's up on the horizon. Clouds that you were seeing before are now behind us because we're going around in a circle as we get ready to relocate our position for all other flights. We're just surrounded in lightning clouds. That's all we're surrounded. Not as hard as the one that we have right behind us, but here we are. Now you can see it again. So it is right behind us, and it is still going.
From the cockpit. They just shut the Atlanta airport again. They got another
line of weather. It's about 120 miles stretching out, as you can see it on the right hand side. There's absolutely no way of getting into Atlanta. So I'm sitting holding and I'm waiting for the weather to clear. They want us to divert to Pensacola and get some more gas, wait for the weather to clear.
We can't get in Atlanta. It's impossible because of this thing. As you can see, it is just not going to happen.
I was joking.
We left Orlando after 9:30. We are near Atlanta, and you can see there is no way we're going to get in it. At least not yet. From it, and there's no way we can get in it. Once again, the seatbelt warning has been announced, and this is. You can't see the whole thing. We're only seeing like maybe one fifth of the whole thing. Maybe one eighth, because this thing is immense. Going on 14 minutes non-stop, and like I said, this has been going on for 20 minutes before that, 20 to 30 minutes before that, since we were approaching the area. Of it. top side, there's that anvil formation. Right there. Yeah, definitely right there. Towards the left, but that is definitely the heart of it. And there's another one coming on the left side. Yes. But we're looking right at the heart of it. It's just non-stop. I've never seen so much lightning in one spot in my life. As fast too. Yeah, here's the other one over here. About to circumnavigate again. We're totally beside the line of storms. It is one huge line. Can't see the beginning, can't see the end, but we definitely know where the most activity is. To the worst, the left side. The wingtip is covering where the activity is, and there's more towards the left of our view. I can see on the ground some kind of stadium. Gonna be in Hartsville anytime soon. When we were in Orlando, we were on the tarmac and we were on hold, and they shut down the engines while we were on the tarmac, and we were there for 15 to 20 minutes before we actually started the engines again and actually had clear for takeoff. By that time, it was already past 9:30. The pilot let us know that they just wanted to save fuel. I'm so happy they did. Background lights, and there's still more in front of us. Yeah, thank you for that. Yep, there's goes our show. There's plenty, folks.